So it does not matter your ton mile calculation. Always remember, you should assess the drilling line yourself. And these are the typical wear areas. So you can see, these are typical wear areas. So you are the one who will decide, irrespective of your ton mile calculation, you will decide when you will want to slip and cut. Okay. So typically we will show you today how to slip and cut or change the drilling line in the same activity. So today we'll discuss about changing the drilling line or slip and cut. So these are the load bearing areas. So the drilling line normally gets worn on these areas, or the crown area over there, or the drum area. So first we have to hang off the block. So we have to take the load off the block, which is very, very important. Empty the drum and then disconnect the dead end by clamping one end to an area where it's available to the mast. So clamp to a provision on the mast or find a way to secure the drilling line. Disconnect the drawworks end clamp and take off the drilling line from the drum carefully. All right. So now we have secured the drilling line. All right. We will now free the deadline anchor bolts and keep them a bit secure. So using a wire rope snake, we'll connect the new drilling line with the old drilling line from the deadline anchor. All right. So there you go. Clamping device between the new and the old drilling line should be fit for purpose. Then you can change the drilling line when your mast is up. So this is totally a manual operation. You keep feeding the line from here and you keep dragging the line out from here. Okay. So this is a typical manual operation. So you will see now how the new drilling line is going in place. The hangoff line is in place and you will see how the new drilling line is going back into the crown assembly, the traveling block, and slowly we are releasing and pulling from here and rolling the drilling line. There you go. Super good. And super easy change of the entire drilling line. You can use the same method for slip and cut, but you have to be a bit careful. It's a very, very interesting operation if it is well managed. Hang off line in place, load out. There is no load on the drilling line, so you have to be a bit careful and manage your clamping, fit for purpose clamps. And then you can replace your drilling line when you are masked up. So you need to release from the deadline anchor and you need to disconnect the clamp from the drawworks and keep maneuvering, pulling. And that's how, pulling from the drawworks and release from the new line from the deadline anchor. And that's how you can change your drilling line in place. So the new drilling line has arrived and we have to find a way to clamp it over here, and then easily we can clamp it to the drawworks. So now you can install the drawworks end clamp, torque it correctly. But remember, see, I've used a clamp on top, which makes it much more easier for me to install the drawworks end clamp. This is very, very important. So release enough line so that you can take the top drive to the accurate stopping point. You could definitely have a few wraps extra. So install your deadline anchor clamp and torque it as per the values. Let's remove the hangoff line now. Let's remove this dead man clamp on the drilling line, on the load end of the drilling line, which is hooked up to the drawworks, and let it be free now. Let's take the wraps from the drawworks now. Very good, eh? Wrapping well. All as per the plan. Very good job. New line in place. Everything looking good. Absolutely amazing job, eh? Drilling line replaced, all bolts stuck, and we are good. We can run in and we can pull out. So the remaining drilling line will remain in its spool, intact there in the drilling spool.